You know, it's been said before that when you look at what people celebrate, you can see what they value. When you look what people applaud, what they get excited about, what they put time, energy, and effort into, when you see that, you can see what they value, how much it means to them. I mean, hopefully here at Our Savior, I mean, you can see that what we get excited about is Jesus and Jesus alone. That because of what he's given and done for us, we have life. And hopefully you can see that what we're excited about is living love as we love Jesus, as we strive to serve him and grow in our relationship with him and become more Christ-like. As we love Jesus, love people, and serve the world. I mean, that's what we're excited about here at Our Savior. But I just want you to take back, okay, and I want you to see we are on the very precipice of the Mount Everest of Western celebrations, aren't we? I mean, we are on the precipice. I mean, we're climbing, we're there. I mean, celebration of Christmas and the Christmas season, the holiday season, I mean, it is on. And when you take a look at what our culture values, when you take a look at what our culture gets excited about, what does it teach us about our culture? Because straight up, there's nothing like this season. I mean, this season gets a lot of attention. And once again, I love Christmas. I get all excited. I was listening to 100.7 like 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks ago, 100.7 was already playing Christmas music. Now the Joy FM 91.5 is playing Christmas music 24/7 all the way through New Year's. I mean, I love it. I love the lights. I've got one tree up already. I'm going to put another one up today and start stringing lights. That's not my favorite part of Christmas, but I love the lights. I mean, I love going to the malls. I love all of the excitement. I love it all. I really and truly do. But you know, you got to understand, you know, from this point on, we are going to be absolutely positively bombarded without mercy. You are going to be pelted with advertisement after advertisement after advertisement. And they all have one particular message. And that's what I kind of want to dig into today a little bit. I want to dig underneath that message that you and I are being fed, that we're drinking in and day out. You see, because I think there's a spiritual dynamic to the message that we're receiving. There's some spiritual warfare that's going on. And I'll maintain that many of us, we just don't spot it. We just don't recognize it for what it is. And so I want to challenge the way that you think, okay? And here's the message that we have been receiving since October 31st, when I saw the first Lexus commercial come on. All right? I mean, the bow was on October 31st. Okay? And this is the message. It's oversimplified, but this is the message that we are receiving over and over and over again. Your life stinks. Your life stinks. And you're missing out. Okay? And that's what it is. The message that we are hearing over and over again is you are missing out. You're missing something and your life stinks. But don't fear. I mean, never fear, the season is here, and we have the answer. We have what you need to fulfill your life, to give you peace, to give you satisfaction, contentment, and joy. You know, and all of a sudden, we get pelted with these advertisements of things that we just need to go out and buy or achieve or experience. You got to get out and start shopping now. Why? Well, there's supply chain issues. We don't know if the product that you want is going to be there in a couple of weeks or not. And so you got to get out there and you got to get it now. If you want to be happy and fulfilled, you want your family to be content, got to get out there and get it. And you better hurry up. And the truth is, sometimes it's not stuff. Sometimes it's an idea. Right? Like Clark Griswold had this revisionist history, right? How yesteryear was perfect and how Christmas when I was a kid was just everything was just right. And so we have this idea of having the perfect Christmas celebration, the perfect holiday celebration. And it might even be the nostalgia of things. You know, like Pastor Futch, who binge watches the Hallmark Station. You know, I mean, he's there, he's watching the Hallmark Station all the time. And you know, he's thinking to himself, you know, if only it would snow. And I could end that whole, you know, I give a kiss to my wife and everything would be just right, just perfect. So it's not just stuff. There's the idea. There's the nostalgia. The fear that we're lacking something. The fear that we're missing out. And my friends, the marketers, they bait us. They bait us and we just get sucked in. I mean, oftentimes it's even unintentionally, right? We just get sucked into this train of thought. Well, my challenge for you this morning, and over the next couple of weeks, I wanted to give you some lenses to which you can see clearly. Okay, you can see clearly what's taking place this season. And I want you to enjoy the season. I mean, I do. And I don't want you to lose any of the excitement. I want you to participate. I want you to go over to Busch Gardens and go to Christmas Town. I want you to go to the malls. And I mean, I want all of the excitement, all of the lights, and all of that good stuff, the singing. But I don't want you to buy into the lies. And at the end of it all, be frustrated. And be disappointed in what took place. I want you this season to experience the joy that is really part of this season. I want you to be reinvigorated, re-energized. I want you to experience the hope, the certainty that this season brings.